but I want to begin and welcome us to day one of Warrior 30. I'm so excited to be doing this challenge with you guys for the next 30 days. Welcome to today's workout, Warrior. So this week is Move Week, and what that means is I don't give an F about how you move your body. You could literally do jumping jacks for 20 minutes. Doesn't sound like the most exciting thing ever, but you could do that. You could go for a walk. You could dance around your house for 20 minutes, or you could show up and do a warrior workout with us for 20 minutes. Katie Lee went on a hike this morning, so she's getting a full, who knows, out couple hours of activity. I don't care how you move your body. It's about what you feel like you can do today, and then building the habit of showing up consistently for yourself. I did a little post on our Facebook group this morning, just 8 minutes, not long-winded, but just kind of like orienting you to what this week is about. Each week's gonna have a different theme, and you're gonna see that reflected in what we talk about and in what we're doing in the workouts. So on that note, today we're hitting shoulders, my favorite day of the week. You need a set of dumbbells and a mat. We're gonna do a shoulder warm-up, which you're gonna see in a second, and I use a band for that. I use a long resistance band, but you could use body weight, or you could grab the nearest broomstick to your body and use it for this warm up too. So we're basically just making shoulder circles. So you can really just use your arms. I'm gonna do the demo for this, 22 minutes. We're doing our 3-circuit normal setup. So on that note, we're gonna start off with band warm ups, which we'll take around the head. I raise one arm, I bring it around the head to the front, and then the other one. The key here is you don't want your arms to chase each other. You want each arm to move kind of on its own. So when one arm is up overhead, the other arm is down. So it's like a 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock situation. And then when one arm is finished moving, then you move the other one. We're gonna do that for 60 seconds to warm up. Then you're gonna grab your dumbbells, and we're doing a set of overhead jumping jacks to start us off, wake us up, get our heart rates going. So we jump and press at the same time. Then we're gonna do a slow set of chicken wing lateral raises. For chicken wings, our elbows are bent and we stay in that 90 degrees, lifting to shoulder height and back down. I think about leading with my elbows when I do this exercise. For circuit two, we're starting off with front side glides. So you're gonna raise one arm to the front, one arm to the side, glide it over, and bring it back down. Nothing moves here but your arms. So you don't want your body to swing, just the arms move. Then I'm gonna double up my weights. You can use one weight or double up as well. We're gonna hit a squat, upright row. So I'm dragging the weights up my body, leading with my elbows. Halfway, we're gonna switch to the other side. That's a 45-second circuit, or 45-second exercise. Last but not least, for circuit two, we're hitting alternating Arnold's presses. So for this, you start with your palms at your shoulders, facing you, and we're gonna alternate opening it up, so palm faces out, pressing up, and returning it the way we came. Circuit three is gonna start off on the ground with a side plank hold. You can do your side plank modified like this, both knees down, one knee down, top leg straight, feet staggered, so top leg in front and bottom leg behind, or feet stacked. So that's four different things. This is obviously the easiest, and stacked is obviously the hardest. Test yourself, where are you at? We're gonna do some hip dips in that side plank, bringing our hips to the ground, tapping and then lifting up. So the whatever obliques and butt cheek are closest to the ground is what you're working. We're gonna stay on the ground and we're gonna hit seated front raises. So we're gonna go single, single, double for these. Palms will face the ground and you're gonna raise up to shoulder height, single, single, and a double. And we're gonna finish with a sit up to overhead press, burnout, right there. And that's gonna finish our workout today. Then we have a pop-up challenge. We're gonna have these pop-up challenges throughout our month. So every now and then I'm gonna say pop-up challenge, and this is what we're doing today, a 2-minute plank challenge. So at the end of the workout, we're doing one 2-minute plank challenge I don't care how modified you do it. All I care is that you do it and you give your best effort. All right, guys. Team, are you ready? Woo! I'll take that enthusiastic silence as a yes. Okay. So Katie Lee had this idea so that you could hear the music. If you want to play the playlist on Spotify, you guys will mute yourselves and we'll just start at the top of the playlist. So if you wanted to hit Spotify on the Warrior Team playlist on your end, just so you have the clear music, because apparently like through Zoom it's a little funky, then you can totally do that. I popped the link to the Spotify playlist in the Warrior Team Facebook page. So if you want to do that tomorrow, cool. Alright. Okay. I sent you a message today, Shay, so you'll be fine. Alright. Team, 30 seconds. Hey Mo, what's up girl? 30 seconds till we start. We're starting off with our band warm-ups, but let's just move our feet. Grab your band. Alright guys, here we go. Give me some good big shoulder circles. One arm around and down. Circle it nice and big. Stretching your chest, stretching your shoulders, your back, your lats, everything. Nice big circle. Let's switch directions, going in the opposite way. Remember, don't let your arms chase each other. One arm goes around, straight, and then the other arm comes around. Straight arms. If you can't keep your arms straight, I would say grab wider on the band. One arm around first, and then the other. One arm around. We're switching to overhead jumping jacks in five. Drop your band. Grab your dumbbells, weights up by your shoulders, jumping jacket out. Go. Nice deep breaths. Woo! Just letting our body warm up. Anything we do with overhead presses, arms overhead, is gonna jack our heart rates up. So make sure you're taking some deep breaths. Good, let's bring it slow, chicken wings. Elbows are bent 90 degrees. Raise the elbows to shoulders and back down. Nice and slow and controlled. I'm even going too fast, so I'm gonna slow it down. 3 seconds up, 3 seconds down. 3 seconds up, 3 seconds down, one more. Good. Our active rest is speed skaters or Apollo Onos. That's when you reach down to the floor, switch your feet, keep it slow, let your body recover, but keep it moving. You can also use active rest to grab a sip of water or just take a little walk, take a lap around the room. Good, you guys. All right, switch back to your bands. We have another minute of band warm-ups. So maybe you're a little bit more stretched out and you can grab a little closer on your band. As long as you can keep your arms straight, you know that you are good. We want this to be a stretch, not a force. Switch directions, lead with the other arm now, bring it over and behind. Ooh. Nice shoulder circles, big ones. Good. Rows, have your arms a little bit less moving together. So I want you to bring your left arm behind your head first, and once it's down, then you're gonna lift your right arm. You'll get a better stretch that way. 3 seconds, drop your bands. Let's go overhead jumping jacks, right in. Push them up, push them up, push them up. Good. Arms straight. Push them up. Yeah. 6 seconds. 3, 2. Give me some slow chicken wings. 3 seconds up. 3 seconds down. Three seconds up. Leading with your elbows. 90 degrees in the elbows. Good job. Yes, you guys. 5 seconds here. Hold your arms at the top where they are. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop your weights. Active rest. Apollo Onos. Ah, let that oxygen just fill your lungs. Three, two, and one. Grab your band. We're doing 1 more minute of this warm-up band exercise. Let's go both arms back behind the head this time. So again, goal, keep your arms straight. Still get the stretch in your chest and shoulders. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. So you bring the band back behind you. Straight arms, you guys. If you can't keep your arms straight, just grab the band wider. Chest up to the sky. Good. Really allow yourself to feel it. We get so tight in our chest from sitting on all the time and looking at our phones and just shrugging our shoulders down. So this is key, especially on shoulder days or chest days. All right. Drop that band. Let's go into our last set of overhead jumping jacks. Let's go, right in. Nice, guys. Like that variation, Shay. Come on, Mo. Yeah, girl. 8 seconds. Now 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. 30 seconds of rest. Get a sip of water. We're starting circuit 2 with front side glides. Then we're doing our squat, upright row, singles. Then we're doing our alternating Arnold presses. 15 more seconds of rest. Guys are doing great. Circuit 1 is down. All right, grab your dumbbells. Front side glide, starting in 5, 3, 2, and 1. Front side, glide them over, back down. Your arms are the only thing that's moving. If you find yourself all of a sudden facing the direction that your arms are going, you know you're moving your shoulders or your hips. You want your shoulders and your hips to face forward the whole time. Think headlights pointing forward. The only thing that's moving around your body is your arms. Last 3 seconds. Good, you can double up your weights in one hand or keep both weights, one in each hand. We're gonna squat, upright row, one side. So I'm going all right side. Squat, drag the weight up the body, leading with the elbow. Excellent. Good job. Good. switch sides after your last one and right in. We have a really short rest in this set, so get ready. We're hitting Arnold overhead, Arnold presses next. Good, let's set up for that. Both weights back in both hands. Palms face you, elbows are at shoulder height. Open up one side, press it up, bring it in. Alternate, open up the other side, press it up, bring it in. So this exercise is gonna take us right up to the start of the circuit again. No active rest here. We're just keeping it moving for the full 7 minute circuit. We got it. Very nice. 10 more seconds. Last five. Those elbows up, 3, 2, and we're going right into front side glides. Keep your core super strong on these. That means your knees are bent. Your hips are tucked under. If you feel like your lower back is arching, you wanna Steve Urkel it. Tuck your hips under. Let your core and your glutes give you a strong foundation. We have 8 seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Both in one hand. Squat upright row. Exhale when you stand. Inhale, going down. Exhale to stand. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, switch sides. Right in. Great, you guys. Stomach squeezes, glute squeezes at your stand. Whew. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. I'm having grip issues. From the top, last round of circuit 2. Up, over, and down. Bring it up, over, and down. Up, over. 3, 2, double it up, squat and row it. I wanna hear your breathing so loud that I can hear it through Zoom. 10 seconds. We have 5, 3, 2, and switch it, other side. If I can get a better grip this time. There we go. There's an art to dumbbell crossing, I have learned. Nice, warriors. 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, and one. Give me your Arnold. Woo! Elbows stay up. I skipped this exercise in the second set. been doing this for 2 years. You know, I think I'd be used to it by now. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job, put them down. All right, circuit 3 is coming at us and we're on the floor the whole time. We're in a side plank hold and then we're doing some hip dips. Then we're gonna flip over and do the same thing on the other side plank. Then we have seated front raise and sit-ups with our overhead press. Whew. So come on down to your side. Your elbow is right under your shoulder. Your shoulder is right over your elbow. I put my hand flat on the floor, so a lot of the weight is in my forearm. This is a great shoulder stability as well as core exercise. When you're ready, lift your hips up. We're gonna hold it here. I want you to wrap your core in like you are wrapping a corset around your torso. Squeeze your bottom butt cheek and those abs that are closest to the floor. We're gonna go up and down for hip dips in 3, 2, 1. Dip your hips down, tap the floor, push back up to side plank. If you need to drop a knee, take it. It's all about what you can do. 3, 2, switch sides. Right in, holding first, reacquaint yourself. Bottom butt cheek is squeezing. Bottom obliques are squeezing. Hip dips up and down, let's go. Five, four, three, two, and one. Grab your dumbbells. Sitting straight up, we're raising right out in front, single, single, together, palms face down the whole time. Try not to bounce off the floor. Move with strict momentum and control. Very nice. Single, single, last one. Okay, bring the weights right under your chin. Roll down to the floor. You're gonna sit up, press the weights up overhead, roll down, and keep going. Roll it down, sit it up all the way, chest tall, big press. Last 3, 2, and 1. Great job. We're going right into our side plank. Oh yes, we are. So hit whatever side plank works for you. Hold it there. We're gonna dip it up and down in 5 seconds. Wrapping, wrapping, wrapping. Dip it, go. Dip up. Good, you guys. Last 3 seconds, 2, and 1. Other side. Just swivel it around, get right in. Holding, find your ground, find your stability, find your core, find your breath. Side planks are freaking hard. They are such a challenge. We're gonna dip it up and down in 3, 2, and go. Excellent job, you guys. Come on. 3, 2, and 1. Grab your dumbbells. Single, single, double. Front raise. Five seconds. 3, 2, 1, sit ups, overhead press. Slow those weights up. You're stronger than that shoulder pain trying to get you to stop. Take a breath, keep going. Woo! Last 5 seconds. 3, 2, and 1, and you know, turn it right over, side plank. Get there and hold it. Squeezing all the muscles in your legs, your glutes, your core. Open your chest up to the side, completely open. Let's go, dip it. 10 seconds of dips. Three, two, swivel it over to the other side. Hold it. Get ready to dip in three, two, up and down, go. Three seconds, two, and one. Have a seat, front raise, right in. Keep going, don't even think about it, just go. Come on, up, up, and up again. Come on, single, single, double it up. Last one. Good, weights under the chin. Roll it down, sit it up. And then jump right back into it. Okay, 2 minutes, you guys. The last time I did a 2 minute plank challenge, I couldn't even tell you when, so. We just start where we're at, right? Okay, get ready. We're starting in 5 seconds. Three, two, one, set it up. Feet wide, hands right under your shoulders, or if you're on your elbows, your elbows are right under your shoulders. I'll give you guys the counts as we're getting chipping away at our 2 minutes. Nice deep inhales and exhales. We're 30 seconds in. Squeezing my glutes tighter. This is a mental challenge. You're all physically strong. It should challenge you. Woo! Awesome job, you guys. That's a minute. Whew. Focus on your breath, your superpower. Light it up, come on. We're almost at a minute and a half. Whew. 30 seconds to go, you guys. We got this. I am strong, I'm powerful, I'm a mother effing warrior. Come on. 15 seconds. Squeeze your butt. Deep breath. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and done. Woo! Yes! Great job, you guys. How was that? Day one is done. Awesome job. Remember how you did on that plank challenge, because spoiler alert, we're gonna have more coming up throughout this workout. Fabulous job. I hope that challenged you. I hope that pushed you past. It was certainly un-freaking comfortable for me. What's up, Mo? Let's close this workout out. Amazing job today. This is about building consistency, about showing up for yourself, even when you don't feel like it in the moment, because you know what this workout gives you, or you know what moving your body gives you, and you are committed to having that or creating that every single day. Super proud of you guys. Let's close it out with some deep breath work. One hand over the chest, one hand on the belly. We're doing some belly breaths. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Closing our eyes, just getting centered, soaking up all of the delicious energy we just created, and also bringing our body back down, calming us, grounding us into grounded mode, as I like to call it. Deep inhale fills your belly with air. Long extended inhale. Exhale expels it out. How does it feel physically? The sensation of pushing yourself, challenging yourself. What are you feeling? Soak that in. That is your short-term reward, but there are so many long-term rewards. One more deep breath in together. Let it out with a big sigh. Fabulous job today. If you have not done your goal planning, check out the post, check out the goal planning sheet. Two major goals for the month of June. One is a fitness goal and one is something, whatever, that is important to you. It could have to do with nutrition. It could have to do with just, I don't know, educating yourself, spirituality, connecting with other people, reading more, getting outside more, whatever. It could have nothing to do with fitness, but it is important to you. So two goals. We set those two goals that we are aiming to achieve, pushing ourselves, stretching ourselves to achieve by the end of June. And then three things that you need to handle in your life to make that happen. Is it a schedule shift? Is it talking to somebody in your household to allow you to have that time for yourself? Is it getting up an hour earlier? Is it reaching out to people and asking to have a conversation? Is it putting in your schedule, blocking out the time, this is when I work out, or this is when I am doing my 20 minutes of reading, whatever. So if you have questions, please reach out to me. I'm sending you guys all an email today just so I can get on the same page as you and I can know what your goals are and I can help you along with that too and get clear. I want you guys to have a successful month. I believe we will have a successful month. So keep telling yourself, because every time you do, you believe it even more. Who are you, warrior? I'm strong. I'm powerful. I'm a warrior. And I'm ready for what's next. I'm ready for this month, and I'm ready for Monday. Love you guys. Have an amazing day. Mwah. Bye.